Hello and welcome to Say It in Polish YouTube channel. Thank you very much for joining me today. I would like to welcome new subscribers and also all of you who are with me from the beginning of this channel. I prepared today some useful phrases which we can link to our body, so I hope you will find it interesting. If you would like to receive vocabulary list for this lesson, you need to go to our Facebook group. It's called Say It in Polish Learners Group. And if you have any question related to this video, just put them in comment section below. Let's get started. First phrase is trzymać kciuki, trzymać za kogoś kciuki, which means keep fingers crossed. You may say trzymaj za mnie kciuki or trzymaj kciuki, and it's used when you are asking someone for support, for keeping fingers crossed for you. And if you want to show your support, you will say trzymam za ciebie kciuki. Trzymam za ciebie kciuki, or simply trzymam kciuki. So let's hear it again. Trzymaj za mnie kciuki. Trzymaj za mnie kciuki, or simply trzymaj kciuki. And when giving support, you will say trzymam za ciebie kciuki. Trzymam za ciebie kciuki, or trzymam kciuki. Trzymam kciuki. I would like to show you that in Poland we keep our fingers for someone a little bit different than it is in English. So we keep, these are thumbs, so we keep them like that. Trzymam kciuki. So now I may say trzymam za was kciuki. Trzymam za was kciuki. Our second phrase is podać komuś pomocną dłoń. Podać pomocną dłoń, which in English means to lend a hand. And we can use it in example. Prawdziwy przyjaciel zawsze poda pomocną dłoń w potrzebie. Prawdziwy przyjaciel zawsze poda pomocną dłoń w potrzebie. And our third phrase is Polish proverb. Co dwie głowy, to nie jedna. Co dwie głowy, to nie jedna. If you struggle with something or if you have a problem, it's always best to ask someone to look at the problem, to help you, to give you support. And then maybe that person will find the solution, maybe just give you support and you will find the solution. So we can use it in following example. Nie martw się, poradzimy sobie. Co dwie głowy, to nie jedna. Nie martw się, poradzimy sobie. Co dwie głowy, to nie jedna. So it's translate, don't worry, we will handle it, we will resolve the problem, because there are two of us, not only you. You are not on your own. And now we have another Polish proverb, and it is kłamstwo ma krótkie nogi. Kłamstwo ma krótkie nogi, which translate as a lie has no legs, or a lie always reveals itself, or a lie cannot live forever. Let's hear it in an example. Pamiętaj, by zawsze mówić prawdę. Kłamstwo ma krótkie nogi. Pamiętaj, by zawsze mówić prawdę. Kłamstwo ma krótkie nogi. And our last expression, last phrase is koniec języka za przewodnika. Koniec języka za przewodnika, which you can translate a tip of your tongue should be your guide. Koniec języka, tip of a tongue, za przewodnika. You should use it as a guide. So it's used when you are asking, you are lost somewhere and you should ask for directions, or if you have some questions and you need answer. We may use it in following example. Jeśli się zgubisz w Krakowie, nie martw się. Koniec języka za przewodnika. Jeśli się zgubisz w Krakowie, nie martw się. Koniec języka za przewodnika. So basically, if you are lost in Krakow, don't worry. You should ask someone how to get where you want to go and there will be always someone to help you. That's everything for today. If you like the video, please subscribe to my channel and give this video thumbs up so I will know that it was useful for you. If you want to watch another video about parts of the body and about useful phrases and maybe some other proverbs, let me know and I will prepare something. Thank you and see you next time.